My name is Mary Canisales, MaryCanisales. I was at ASU for 4 years and completed my degree, and still that class with the flipped classroom makes the biggest difference. I've taken that, I've used those study skills and turned it into my other classes and applied them there. But the biggest thing I think is being able to apply the information. So I'm not just memorizing information, I'm learning it in a way that I can really use it in real life with patients and things like that. Usually from the science classes I've taken, there's so much information in a science class. It's overwhelming. That's, I think, the biggest part. It's overwhelming as a student to get all of this information just thrown at you. I described it to her as, in my other science classes, I feel like they just throw a bunch of laundry on the table. Like, here, do what you want with it. And with the flipped classroom scenario, what happens is I feel like, okay, here's the whites, here's the darks, and here's the coloreds. And it's almost an easier way to kind of sort through this massive amount of material. The assignments are broken down in a way where you have something due every day. You're accountable every day in the classroom, whereas other classrooms, it's just like, oh, we have this huge assignment due on this day, or next week we have this due. Where it's more broken down in the classroom, so I feel like it's in manageable pieces where I can kind of, okay, this is due this day, I want to work on this, and this is due the next day, and I can work on that. And so then another thing with that is you're repeating the material so much that you're getting it more often. I'm reviewing the same information 3 or 4 times to get the, you know, the worksheet or the study guide done. So now I've seen this information 4 times and I've looked at it before she's lectured on it. So that's another thing. I'll sit in a lecture and I'm not engaged. I'm not really comprehending the information because it's the first time I've heard it or seen it. Whereas when you have, like, the lesson builders are really helpful. So lessons builder is due before you come to class. And it's worth a couple points. So it's not just, I mean, you want to do it. You want to get those points. So you do the lesson builder. So now you've already reviewed the material once. And you go into the classroom and you hear her lecture. And now that's the second time you've heard it. So now when you're hearing the lecture, it's making more sense because it's not the first time some crazy terminology, something's been thrown at you. It's, okay, I read about this in Lesson Builder. I remember that. It's helped me manage my other classrooms, but because the structure's not the same and I don't have the same type of deadlines, and it's harder for me to break down the material myself, I think. Like I said, it's kind of like the laundry scenario where I have all this material and I'm like, oh, how do I sort through this in a way where it's going to be useful to my time? It's going to be useful to learning all of this information. So I definitely try to apply it as much as I can, but there's no substitute for her coming in and, you know, here's this study guide and have this done and have this done. And there's not a substitute for it. But I think I've become a better student, definitely more accountable, that sort of thing, because of that type of setting. But it's hard to do it myself.